Buckeye warm-up show. I'm John Gordon along with TJ Ryle from Madison Square Garden in the Big Apple, New York, where tonight in the finals of the 27th annual ECAC Holiday Classic, it's the Ohio State Buckeyes against the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Both teams 5-3 on the year. Both teams victorious last night as Ohio State upset the number one ranked team in the nation, the Duke Blue Devils, 90-84 in overtime. Rutgers came from behind and beat St. John 72-61 to advance to the final game. Should be a good one here tonight. BJ is standing by with the starting lineups and more pregame information on our Buckeye warm-up show. It'll come to you right after this. 60 seconds, time out.
Let's first of all take a look at the Rutgers basketball team and set them for you. Tonight, Adele Anderson will be starting at 6'7". He is a senior and averaging 12.5 points per ball game. Starting at the guard will be Kelvin Troy. Troy, who is a 6'5" sophomore, is averaging 7.2 points per basketball game. And then starting at the center position is 6'9" Jim Bailey, and he's out of Boston, Massachusetts. 6'9" at 230 pounds, averaging 17 points a game. Darryl Strickland will start, and Darryl is 6'6" at 185 from Jersey City, averaging 12.7 per game. And the other guard position will be filled by senior 6'2" Tom Brown. Brown averaging 5.1 points per basketball game. The Ohio State Buckeyes tonight will be starting a different lineup than we have started in the five previous basketball games. It'll be the same five that was on the floor for the biggest part of last night's second half comeback against the Duke Blue Devils. And by that we mean that Carter Scott has earned a starting position on the Ohio State basketball team for tonight's game as he replaces senior Mike Klein in the starting lineup. Carter will be starting at a forward, actually, 6'2". And Carter comes into the game tonight after his 19-point effort last night with an 8.1 average per game. Starting at the other forward position will be Big Jim Smith. Big Jim is 6'8", 218 pounds, a sophomore from Cleveland ECAC, averaging 9.5 points coming into this championship game of the ECAC Basketball Classic. At the center will be Herb Williams. And Herb's efforts last night were as written this morning in the New York Times. They said that Herb Williams ate Kaminsky alive in the second half. He certainly had a superb final 20 minutes action from center Herb Williams. Herb is averaging 19.8 coming into the game tonight. He's 6'10", and of course, sophomore from Columbus. At the guard will be Kelvin Ransey. Kelvin, the junior from Toledo, averaging 21.5 points per game. And Todd Finn of Columbus, about a sophomore, averaging 6.4 per contest.
Away by Ramsey, a free ball by Cowan up it is. Oh, what a play! up and in, and it's a 4-2 Buckeyes lead. We're out against 10, front courting, right sideline. We'll get the matchups in just a moment. Low for Bailey, turnaround against 10, and it's up and good. Both ball clubs scoring almost at will at the beginning of the game. Just over a minute gone, and it's a 4-2 count. Here's the 4-4, and it's high. Cutter Scott. Ransey out on top, 18-footer, yes. Buckeyes are 3-for-3 in the early going. Ransey was 4, Williams was 2. Brown in the backcourt, Penner's on it. And it gets to the front court on the left sideline. Leaves it on the wing for Troy. Troy into the corner to Anderson for a jump that's up and short. No good. The rebound to Jim Smith. Excuse me, that was Bailey shooting. Anderson. Cutter Scott on the left. This shot is up and missed. And the rebound picked away by Troy. He'll get it up court in a hurry now to Brown. Brown gets it low to Bailey with the little foul on Jim Smith. Bob Williams, excuse me. His first, Team 1 Ohio State. Common foul. Rutgers will get the ball out of bounds. Bringing the ball inbounds will be Strickland. Underneath the Rutgers basket on the right, he gets it out to Brown. On the right wing, Brown now with an over dribble off of the left to Anderson. Faking left, driving right, 10-footer, no. Rebound, Cutter Scott loses it. Strickland missed, but it's tapped in. And I believe the tap will go to Anderson. Anderson gets the tap and the bucket, and it's a 6-6 tie. Anderson's second basket of the game. Cutter Scott, right side, out to Ransey. Ransey against the 3-2 zone, brings it off of the left to Penn. Low left baseline, Jim Smith, turnaround, jump up and good. Smith with his first basket, he had 10 last night. Buckeyes lead at 8-6, 17:26 to go. This is Law Brown with a drive underneath the Troy. The shot up, but he does not count on a travel violation called against Kelvin Troy. Playing a 2-3-3-2 zone. Ransey on the right, the Buckeyes for a 4-point lead. Smith trying to get a hold of Williams, banged away and picked off by Troy. He'll bring it back outside to Brown. Brown to Strickland for a drive in the lane. The shot is up. To go, first half of play, just underway from Madison Square Garden. Happy to have you with us here on WBNS and the Sports Ohio Network. Curb gets it low to Jim Smith. Turnaround shot is up and in. Let's see if it counts. Foul on the play. Basket count. And the line for one will be Jim Smith. And free throw good. Brown, front courting on the right. To Bailey, high posting, driving on the left. Whistle. Foul. Herb Williams. And they'll give it to Strickland. Strickland on a high post to Bailey at the free throw line. 16-footer, yes. Bailey from 16 on a switch, and it's a 10-11 game. Buckeyes with the lead in the ball. Ransey right side out to Penn against the 3-2 zone. Off to Carter Scott. Scott now to Penn on the right. Low for Herb. He's got it. Baseline. Turn around. Jump. No. Tap Jim Smith. Rebound battle for who's got it? Rutgers and lost. Five Rutgers at last touch out of bounds by Ohio State Jim Smith. Inbounding will be Strickland. He'll get it to Brown. He's the quarterback with a left-handed dribble. He's to the front court against Pat Penn to the left side. Stopping in the wing. Leaving it off for Bailey for a drive and a shot. A 4-point lead, 15-11. Buckeyes in red, 11-8. And a Jim Smith 3-point play. Klein is in now for Ohio State. And he replaces Pat Penn. Scott on the left. Driving to the baseline. Jumping from 12. It's up and good. Scott, who had 19 last night, tying his varsity career high. And he gets his first 2 points of the night. It's a 2-point game. This is Brown, front courting for Rutgers. Off to Strickland, high to Bailey, turnaround, jump, no. Rebound, Herb Williams. Williams with the outlet pass, he didn't make it. He now dribbles the ball to the front court. He gets it on the left wing to Carter. Jump from 12 down. The rebound. Jim Smith. He lays it up and missed it. Got rebounds on the left. Puts it up again. No good. And a jump ball is going to be called. Well, Jim Smith went for the dunk on the right side and he couldn't get it in. Got a rebound to miss Jim Smith's shot, and he's tied up in a jump ball. It looks like it's going to be James Bailey. So Bailey 6'9 against Carter Scott 6'3, and the top control to Rutgers, top board. Well, front court, right sideline. They lead by 2, 15-11. Trying to get it low to James Bailey, and Jim Smith fouls on the foot. James Bailey, and Herb Williams is on Abdel Anderson. Outside, Strickland. Off to Anderson in the right wing. Back out to Moore, who controls the loose pass. Left-handed dribble, looks low, nobody free. Gets it in the lane now to Troy. Turn around, jump on the right. No. Rebound, Herb Williams. Take it away from Anderson. Bucks off and running, trailing by 2. Herb on the right, stopping, shooting is good. Herb Williams did it all. Rebound, it dribbled the ball the length of the floor and put up a 12-footer to tie it again. 15-15, 14-18 remaining. First half of play. Moore against Ransey, spinning outside. On the left, low for Anderson. Turn around again, fire up it in. Anderson to the hoop, and he gets the basket. That'll be his third of the game. He's got 6 points. Butler, Rutgers by 2, 17-15. This is Carter Scott declined. Anderson to Ransey in the lane, and Ransey puts it up and in. Sixth in the game for Ransey. And the Buckeyes tied up at 17 apiece. Rutgers back the other way tonight in a tie game at the moment. Bailey driving against Ellinghausen. Offensive foul, James Bailey. Well, Ellinghausen had position on Bailey when he went right to the hoop with the ball when he got it. Ran into Jimmy and picked up the offensive foul. This is Scott to the right side, down the wing. Out to Ransey against the zone. Rutgers will stay in that zone almost the entire game. Decline to Ransey at the free throw line on the right side. Ransey now back to the basket. Hook passes on the right to Carter Scott. Low for Herb. Turn around, jump miss. Rebound in the lane. Carter Scott, he puts it up, but he's fouled on the play. And it's going to be called against Tommy Moore. His first, team third, Carter Scott to the line. Scott last year against Stetson in the early goings of his freshman season scored 19. 13-20 remaining. First half of play. Up it is. Brings it to the right sideline. Steps in the wing to Strickland for a jump from 18. Good. Strickland from 18 on the right side. And now it's a tie at 19. Buckeyes back the other way. Scott on the left to Clyde. Looking low. Nobody free. On the wing to Ramsey. Against the 3-2 zone. Back out on top to Scott. To Ramsey on the left to jump from 20. No. And the rebound kept away by Ellinghausen into the hands of Herb. He banks it home. Williams on the left, banks home the missed top by Ellinghausen, and he got it in. Buckeyes by 2 at 21-19. 12:42 remaining. Moore on the left to Anderson. Against Herb, the drive, the shot from 17. It does not go. There's a whistle and a foul underneath on Mike Klein.
In the garden.
Inbounding, Rutgers in the common foul, Ohio State 15, Klein first. Strickland in the right wing, takes the dribble out on top to Moore. Out on the left now to Troy. Back to Moore for a bomb from 22, does not go. Rebound Anderson on the left, he puts it up and it's missed. In the lane, Klein with a rebound. The Buckeyes get it back and try to add to their lead. Right to the front court, right side. The senior from Millersburg into the right corner to Carter Scott. Out to Ramsey. Back to Scott in the wing, and Carter will bring the dribble to the middle of the floor. On the left to Klein. He holds against the zone. Dribbles once and brings it to Scott, who drives the right side. Well, for Herb, as Scott is up and blocked, and a foul called on James Bailey. His second, and that brings Tommy Young up off the floor for Rutgers. And a warning from one of the referees, saying, Mr. Young, get back to that bench or you'll catch a team. Daniel is the first Rutgers sub, and here's Herb missing a pair. Rebound, Klein, loose on the deck, picked up by Moore. And he'll front court it. This is Brown to Strickland, driving on the right. The shot is up, no good. Rebound, Rutgers has got it way up, up and in by Stone. Troy, his first basket, Herb missed both free throws. And the Buckeyes now are tied with Rutgers at 21. Carter Scott on the right to Klein, driving to the right corner, the jump from 18. Short, no good, and the rebound. Troy for Rutgers. And here are the Scarlet Knights to the lead. Tied at 21 with 11:23 to go. First half of play. This is Brown leaving it for Strickland. Roll for McDaniel. Turnaround jump. No good. Pop, no good. And Herb Williams in the rebound. Double teamed. He gets rid of it on an outward pass to Ransey. Quickly to the front court. Into the corner to Scott. Cross on the left to Klein for the drive and the shot. Low, he missed it. Rebound to Rutgers. Picked up by Scott. And Klein, and then a foul underneath. And it's going to be called against Darryl Strickland. Strickland's first, team 5 for Rutgers. Ellinghausen misses the first of a pair. Jimmy again, it's up and in. Buckeyes by one. Rutgers, Clark is into the game, replacing Brown. Whoa, this is a hook. It's up and in by McDaniel with a foul in the play. Ellinghausen draws the foul. And a shot by McDaniel is good, his first basket. Rutgers takes the lead, 23-22, and attempts to add to it with McDaniel at the free throw line. Free throw up and good by McDaniel. 3-point play, Rutgers by two. Looking for Ransey outside, he found him. Kelvin passed his man, 15-footer, no. Rebound tapped away, Herb Williams to Jim Smith. 14-footer by Jim, no good, and the rebound in by Rutgers, score. Off with the Clark, 2-on-1 break. Clark leaves it off for Strickland, 5-footer up with Jim. Now, Strickland with 6 in the game. Rutgers with a 4-point lead, 26-22. Ransey left sideline, off on the right now to Carter Scott. Driving on the wing, low for Jim Smith. Almost went out of bounds. Ransey, baseline jump on the left, no good. And the rebound to Rutgers, Strickland. Ahead to Clark. He gets it to Anderson. He lays it up and misses. Rebound in the lane. Score! And the foul in the corner. Carter Scott draws the foul. His second of the game. Rutgers with their biggest lead. 28-22, and they could take it to 7. At the line will be Kelvin Troy. Here's Troy, free throw up and good. Back the other way, trailing by 7, 29-22. And left corner with the dribble, leaving it outside for Ransey, nearly stolen away, but Kelvin controls. Back to Penn, low for Herb, off his chest and out of bounds. Not playing well at the moment. Rutgers against Pat Penn. Swings it to the right side, steps in the wing and gives to Anderson. Anderson looking low, nobody free. Still holding, brings it back out to Clark. Clark now gets it underneath to McDaniel. Driving against Jim Smith, passing back outside to Clark. Back to Medlinger, now to Clark on the right sideline. Clark directing traffic with a right-handed dribble. Gets it low to McDaniel, turn around to Anderson. The jump is up, but no good. Tony Hall, cross court on the left to Penn. Looking low, nobody free. Back out to Ramsey. Looking out, he gets it to Herb. Turn around, jump. Yep. Williams, he's got 4 baskets of 8 in the game. And the Buckeyes come up a long drive spell with a hook. 31-24.
When McDaniel stepped the ball on the rebound, there was some type of injury that he suffered on that. I don't know if he...
trailing by 7. Here's Ransey to the right side. Out to Tony Hall on top. Hall looks left, dribbles down the leg. To the baseline, jumps it up from 12. Yep, Tony Hall. He gets the hoop, and the Buckeyes now are down by 5 at 31-26. This is Clark with 10 on him. Spinning outside to the right wing to Strickland. Low, banged away by Clark Penn and intercepted by Herb Williams. The pass is intended for McDaniel. Penn in the right corner to Ransey. Hasn't dribbled it yet, now puts it on the floor. Spins outside, makes the jump and brings it off to Todd Penn. Penn in the middle now with a right-handed dribble. Takes it to the right wing to Tony Hall. Looking low, outside to Ransey. The drive by Calvin, 15-footer. Yep, it's good. Ransey's got eight in the game with four field goals, and the Buckeyes are within three. That's 31-28, 7.5 remaining. Here comes Rutgers, back the other way now with a three-point lead. Clark leaving it for Bailey on the left for the drive, spinning it up, it is. Good play by Bailey. Jim Smith beaten by a step, and he takes it right to the hole for the basket. Scott is in, Ramsey's out. Clark and Troy out front of that zone. Bailey and McDaniel underneath. 10 to the right corner. Looking low for Williams. Stolen away by Clark. He has it stolen back by Tony Hall. Hall for a drive and a shot. It's out. No good, but it's tipped in by Herb Williams. Herb with 10 in the game, and the Buckeyes are within three. 33-30. 6:55 remaining. First half of play. Clark low for Bailey. By 5, 35-30, 6:39 remaining. Here's Scott 10, right side, now to the middle. Off to the left of the dribble, leaving it for Carter Scott. Scott driving to the left sideline, has it stolen away, but banged out of bounds. 5-6-1, and we're going to have a timeout here at the Garden. So, 6:28 remaining, first half of play. Timeout on the floor. Rutgers 35, Ohio State 30.
Under here on basket.
Ninth to the top 20. Herb with a turnaround jump. It's up. It's long. No good. Rebound. Tony Hall. He puts it up and in. Hall with 4 points in the game. And the Buckeyes are down by 3 at 35-32. Herb missed, but Hall stuck it back in. Here's Brown back into the game to Madlinger. Off of the left for Bailey. Trying to get it low. He threw it away. It's out of bounds. And the Buckeyes get it back. Bailey's pass is tended low for McDaniel. Bangboard and then banged out of bounds. So the Buckeyes get it back. The pass was intended for Troy. Ohio State down by three, trying to cut into the lead. Kent thinking left, driving right, takes it all the way, looks for a foul, and it's going to be on Todd Tanner, charging zone. It'll be ball control. Rutgers will get the ball out of bounds. Carter's got to Kelvin Ramsey. Brown, right sideline, Rutgers attacking, leading by three to Bailey. Turn around, jump, get it out, no good. Rebound, Carter Scott, left side. Out left to Kelvin Ramsey. Front turning, right sideline, back out to Carter Scott. Now to Ramsey in the right wing. Ramsey, whistle, and a foul is going to be called against Brown. Back on the right. Out to Kelvin Ramsey. Ramsey driving against Darius Griffin, who's into the game now. The drive by Ramsey, the shot. Foul on Griffin, and Ramsey will go to the line. For Griffin, it's his first foul of the game. Ramsey shooting a pair, the first is missed. What a pace. Foul that misses again. So the Buckeyes leading three-star shooters. 83% misses a pair, and it's still a three-point Rutgers lead. The Scarlet Knights attacking. Brown off to Troy. Out on top to Griffin. On the left to Brown. He gets it low for Anderson. Anderson in the left corner now against Herb Williams. Driving, shooting from 12 short. No good. Rebound, Tony Hall. Off and pass for Ramsey. Ramsey driving. Dakota's got him off the jump from 12. It's up and good. On the left, this is McDaniel. Off on the right now to Griffin. Anderson on the wing. Back out to Brown, who makes the jump and then takes it from 14. No good. That's it by McDaniel. McDaniel's got 7 points in a sub roll. 4:25 remaining. 37-34. Rutgers by three. There's Scott outside. On the right to Tony Hall. Back to Scott. The jump from 18. No. Rebound in the lane. Picked up by McDaniel. -5. Brown outside on the right. Looking now and being hugged by Carter Scott. Off to Anderson and then back out to Griffin. Griffin tops to Brown, and he'll dribble against Kelvin Ransey. Now to Griffin on the right, driving to the corner, bringing it back out to Brown. On the left to Anderson. He tries to get it low and does to Troy, but we got a whistle on the foul. Going to be called against Jim Smith. That'll be his second in the game, and Ellinghausen is in for Smith. Here's Calvin Troy with a 1-1. He hits the first. Ellinghausen is in for Smith. Troy again. He missed it. Rebound. Herb Williams. Going away. Rutgers gets it back, leading by 4. 38-34. This is Brown on the left there. Anderson. He'll take it low. Driving against attacking now for Rutgers. Anderson driving on the right. He's got it up. He's got 14 in the game. And Rutgers leads by 6 again, 42-36. Here's Tony Hall on the left to Ramsey. Buckeyes attacking to Hall on the left corner. Out to Ramsey, the jump from 18. Short, no good. Cap Ellinghausen, he missed it. Rebound, Brown, Rutgers. Rutgers down on the left sideline in the front court with a Brown dribble. Holding and bringing it back outside. Rutgers now with 2:20 remaining, leading by 6, and going for an 8-point lead. Griffin on the right, looking low for Anderson. Out to Brown, the jump from 20. Rutgers by 8, 2 minutes to go. And 44-36, Ramsey outside on the left to Hall. Looking low for Herb. Here's the drive by Hall. Can't get it underneath. Gets it to Carter Scott. To Herb. He dribbles it off his toe. But to the hands of Tony Hall. Hall back to Scott. Shot from 14 off the board. No good. Rebound Ellinghausen. He puts it off. For a final shot here. This is Anderson outside. The Scarlet Knights lead by 6. Brown outside. Looking now as he controls the dribble. Minute 6 to go. Out to Anderson. Ellinghausen on him. Now off on the right to Troy. A drive for Troy. A shot for 5 and it's back by Ellinghausen. Into the hands of Carter Scott. Ellinghausen on the left. Ramsey outside to Carter. Scott brings it low for Herb. Drives and he Williams with 16 in the game. The Buckeyes are down by 4, 44-40. 37 seconds remain in the half. This is Brown outside for Rutgers. Off on the right to Anderson. Now to Troy. Back to Brown again. He's on the wing and brings it back outside to Anderson. 21 seconds remaining. Off on the right side, Brown against Carter Scott. Now to Anderson. He holds and brings it back outside. This is Brown with 10 seconds to go. The drive by Brown, a shot from 15. Trailing by 6, 46-40. Bailey against Herb Williams on the jump. Klein starting the second half for Scott 10. Ellinghausen starting for Big Jim Smith. So the Buckeyes lose the tip and Rutgers has it. This is Scarlet outside to Moore Brown. He'll get it on the right to Anderson for a drive and a baseline jump up and no good. Rebound Paley in the lane. On the left, his shot is open off the mark. Rebound Anderson. He's fouled underneath by Clark. Has it in the free throw, up and off the left mark on the right side by Anderson. And it's up, and this one is again off, but Bailey rebounds and then loses the ball to Carter Scott. Aim off to Carter Scott against the 3-2 zone to Clark on the left. Driving to the free throw line on the right to Scott, into the right corner, Ransey. Back out to Scott, back to Ransey. Ransey looking low for Ellinghausen, brings it back out to Scott, underneath the arm to shot, turnaround, no good, the rebound, off to Strickland. He gets it to Brown at the free throw line, he fakes the jump and gives it back to Strickland. Looking low for Anderson, has to bring it back out to Brown, now to Bailey, here's the whistle, and a foul against Jim Ellinghausen.
Down to Ozark last night.
Inbounding on the play, it's a common foul. Rutgers has it. Here's a drive by Strickland. He's shot back, but he gets the rebound. Off to Bailey for a jump that's missed and rebounded by Herb Williams. Buckeyes bring it back the other way. Ransey, 15-footer. Yes, it's good. Ransey with 10 in the game. 41st straight game. He's had double figures for Ohio State. And the Buckeyes have went in two at 46-42. This is Brown for Rutgers. Off on the right to Anderson and then back outside to Brown. 18-footer Brown up and good. Now 48-42, first second half basket for Rutgers. And the Knights lead it by six again. And here's Klein. Off to Carter Scott, stolen away, knocked out of bounds. And last touch by Rutgers, it'll be Ohio State ball.
Shot 32.5% in the first half.
Klein to Ransey on the left. Stops at the wing, brings it out to Klein against the zone, right back to Ransey again. Kelvin looking underneath, nobody free, out on top to Carter Scott, back to Ransey. Now to Scott again, on the right wing to Klein, looking low for Ellinghausen. And brings it back out to Carter Scott for a drive, dishing off to Williams, winged away by Bailey to the hands of Brown. 14 foot on the right, Brown up and in. Rutgers by 8, they went earlier by 9, and it's 50-42. Buckeyes back the other way, having trouble adjusting to the zone. Here's Klein on the left, looking outside for Carter Scott. Brings the dribble to the right, gives to Ellinghausen, right corner, Ransey for a jump from 20, no good. Rebound, Herb Williams, turn around, up it is. Williams now has 18 in the game in his first second half basket. He had 22 last night, 23. 17-13 remaining in the game. 6-8, 6-point lead Rutgers at 50-44. This is Strickland off to Brown. Holding outside and the right to Bailey for a drive. Stolen away by Carter. Got the foul on Carter. For Scott, his third foul of the game. Number two against Ohio State in the second half. Change the foul to Ellinghausen, his third, still the club's third team, and Rutgers has it out of bounds on the common foul. On the right, Brown, low for Bailey, turn around, jump, no, rebound, Herb Williams. Oh, he went high to get it. Herb went past to Ransey, front cutting on the left sideline. To the middle, and then Ransey backing away with a deliberate dribble. And Ohio State trailing by six in a game, 50-44. Here's Klein on the left from Carter Scott into the corner to Ransey for the drive, and he loses the ball. Picked away by Strickland of Rutgers. Kelvin thought he had a foul, but nothing was called. Now Strickland off on the right to Anderson. Here's a drive by Troy. His fake is a pass to Bailey. Turnaround off the board. It's up and good. Bailey now has 9 points in the game. Rutgers leads by 8 again at 52-44. This is Klein and Ransey outside playing catch in the right. Klein fakes the jump and brings it back to Ramsey. Ramsey gives it to Klein in the right corner. He fakes again and brings it out to Ramsey to Cutter Scott in the corner on the left side. Ellinghausen, his jumper no good, and the rebound off to Troy. Rutgers for a 10-point lead. Brown from 18-2, and the rebound, Harb Williams. Outlet to Cutter Scott. Buckeyes running back the other way. Scott slows it down, looks to the right corner, nobody free, and brings it off on the wing to Klein. Back out to Scott and the left to Ramsey. Ohio State trailing by 8, 52-44. 15:30 to go in the game. Here's Klein outside. Off to Ramsey. He's in the middle of the floor. Ramsey now driving on the right. Back to Klein in the right corner. Low for Ellinghausen for a sky hook. He missed it, but it's rebounded by Ramsey. He jumps from 18. No good. We're throwing a foul on Herb Williams. That's third, team four. 11:38 remaining. Rutgers 59, Ohio State 54.
And lots of surprises.
Rutgers leading by 5 in the front court with a Strickland dribble on the right sideline. Spins away from Ramsey and gives it to Anderson at a high post. At the top, he brings it on the left to Strickland. Now off to Troy, right back to Strickland again. To Brown, now to Anderson. He'll hold and give to Troy in the right corner to Brown. Holding now with his hands free and brings it back outside to Strickland. We got 11:14 remaining. And Rutgers now away from the basket. Perimeter passing. This is Brown. He gets it to Bailey against Jim Smith. The shot on the left. Up and no good. Rebound Anderson. He missed it. Jim Smith's third foul of the game. Bailey, one and two shots, free throw good. And up and in. And Rutgers leads by 5. Takes the jump outside. We got Clark back in the game now for Rutgers. Here's Ramsey on the left to Penn. Looking into the left corner, Carter Scott, the jump from 18, no good. And the rebound, Anderson for Rutgers. Madlinger also in the game for Rutgers. He's got it down the right wing. Back outside to Clark. He dribbles to the right hand to the right sideline. Steps to the wing, brings it back outside to Anderson. Now Anderson off to Madlinger. To Clark. He'll hold, looking for Troy. Brings it back again to Madlinger. Now Madlinger gets it low for Troy. Cut around, jump on the left. No good. Rebound Bailey in the lane. Taken away by Ramsey. Loose on the tip. Jim Smith draws the foul, his fourth of the game. And Bailey is at the line for a three-point play. And Rutgers now leads by 8, 7, 63-56.
Over Atlanta, 27-20.
This free throw rebound missed by Anderson. Jim Smith got it. He's fouled by Madlinger. So Bailey missed the free throw. Anderson rebounded. He missed. And then Madlinger fouled Jim Smith. That's only the third team foul against Rutgers here in the second half.
LA and then all winners play next weekend to find out who goes to the Super Bowl.
Ramsey now to Penn. The Buckeyes get it out of bounds in a common foul. Trailing by 7 in the game. Here's Penn at the free throw line to Ramsey. Back to Penn. Fakes the 15-footer. Gets it low for Herb. Turnaround blocked by Anderson. To the hands of Ramsey. The Buckeyes still have it. Now Ramsey looking and getting into the left corner to Carter Scott. Kicked out to Herb. Banged away and a foul to the play by McDaniel. His second, team 4 against Rutgers. And the Buckeyes will get it out of bounds at a common foul. Rutgers has only 14 fouls, 9 minutes, 10 seconds remain in the game. Ed was in the act of shooting, and he hit the first of 2 free throws. Up and in. Herb now got 22 in the game. He leads the Buckeyes in scoring. 9:09 to go. Ohio State trails by 5, 63-58. behind the dribble. He gives off down to Anderson for a drive on the right. That is up and no good. Rebound, McDaniel, the cross. He puts the shot up to Smith, and the rebound comes off to Curtis Scott. And a heavy traffic, Scott leads a fast break to Herb Williams. Jump on the right. No good, and a timely violation against Herb Williams. Foul, Patson. In the backcourt on Billy Clark. Here's Clark at a 1-1, the free throw up and good. He'll shoot another. Shooting in the second of two free throws, he got it. And Rutgers leads by 7. And back to Carter Scott, to Ransey in the left corner. The jump from 20 is good. Ransey now with 20 in the game. And the Buckeyes cut it back to 5 at 65-60. Clark front courting with heavy pressure from Pat Penn. Left side to Strickland. Against Carter Scott on the right to Clark. Low for Bailey. Kicked out of bounds. Last touch by Ohio State. Clark will inbound to Bailey. Out to Madlinger. Off on the right. Now to Strickland. He brings it to Madlinger again. Now to Clark. In the right corner. Strickland to drive on the right. Shot off the board. No good. Rebound. Strickland has got blocked by Williams into the hands of Tadpen. Trying to get it ahead to Ransey and knocked out of bounds by Rutgers. The Buckeyes have it trying to cut the lead to 3. .55 remaining. Inbounding Carter Scott to Herb Williams. Fakes the jump and is fouled on the play by Madlinger, I believe. Inbound to Ransey, right corner. Hugged by Madlinger. Ransey brings it out along the sideline with a dribble and it off the pen in the middle of the floor. Pen to the right. Now off on the left to Carter Scott. The Owls get the low for Jim Smith. Banged out of bounds. Last touch by Rutgers. McDaniel, still Buckeyes ball. Substitution for Rutgers. Anderson back in the game replacing McDaniel. He played awfully well as a sub tonight. McDaniel leaves with 9 points. Inbounding, Carter Scott to Ramsey. Left corner at the pen. Todd with a deliberate dribble now to the middle and the top of the key. Off on the right to Carter Scott, back to Penn. Holding and looking for Ramsey in the corner to Carter Scott. Scott driving on the right, jumping from 12, and it rims it home. Scott's third basket. 8 points in the game for Scott. And the Buckeyes trail by 3, 65-62. Madlinger, front court to the left side. Off to Clark on the right wing now to Strickland. He holds and drives against Carter Scott, stops and pops from 12 up and good. Possible 3-point play for Strickland. He'll go to the line of the Curtis Scott foul. Here's the Strickland free throw for the 3-point play, and he got it. Rutgers leads by 6, 68-62. By Troy, here's Ramsey off to Curtis Scott. Scott with a drive, gets it low for Herb. Turnaround jump, no good. Rebound, Ramsey in the lane, 8-footer, yep. Ramsey gets the rebound, Kelvin now is 22 in the game. The Buckeyes trail by 4, 68-64, 6:41 remaining. On the right, this is Strickland, low for Bailey, Sky Hawk, Bailey's got 20 in the game, and Rutgers up by 670-64 with 6:22 remaining. Here's Penn in the right corner. After Carter Scott on top. He holds, drives to the free throw line, fakes the jump, and then gets the ball back. The Penn in the right, 20-footer, in and out, no good. Rebound Anderson, he threw it away. But last touch by Penn, and it's going to be Rutgers ball.
The Associated Press and UPI top 10 nationally will certainly change somewhat after the developments here. And, of course, we'll have to wait and see what happens at the Notre Dame-Kentucky game later tonight. We have a timeout on the floor. We have 6:08 left in the ball game with the score, Rutgers 70, Ohio State 64. Ohio State trailing by 6.
Rutgers has the ball out of bounds, and here's Strickland driving against Ramsey to the right corner. Brings it back outside to Anderson, now to Brown. He'll hold on top, trying to get it low for Bailey, intercepted by Carter Scott. Ahead to Ramsey, driving on the right, he lays it up and in. Ramsey now has 22 in the game. give him 24 with 12 baskets. It is a steal by Top 10. Knocked out of bounds with Peter's ball. I think it's going to be a foul called against Strickland. It'll be Ohio State ball. Brown draws the foul. 5:41 remaining, and then the Buckeyes trying to cut it down to two. Penn outside, directing traffic, sending Curtis Scott from the left side to the right. To Scott, then back to Penn, now to Scott. Ransey in the right corner, back out to Curtis Scott in the wing. Back to Ransey, the jump from 20. Yes! Ransey! Where is he hot? 26 in the game for Ransey. Two more points, and he's got his 1,000th of his career. And the Buckeyes are now within two at 70-68. Brown to Bailey, driving. Ball stolen away by Curtis Scott. He saved it from going out of bounds. Buckeyes get it back and a chance to tie. 5:05 to go. Hang on now as Pat Penn brings it to the front court to the left sideline. Stops in the wing with a dribble. Looks low for Herb. He's got it. Sky hook. Walks away but to the hands of Penn. Now Penn brings it back out. The Buckeyes still have it. Ohio State wanted a goaltending call, but they didn't get it. Here's Penn on the left wing. In trouble, brings it out to Curtis Scott. Here's Scott now as he moves off to the right. Gets it to Jim Smith. Back out to Ramsey on the right wing. Buckeyes with a hoop to tie it up. Ramsey at the free throw line at the center of the floor. Up to the left of the dribble, back to the basket. Now to Curtis Scott. He looks low, nobody free. Bench is dry, back to the basket, spins and brings it out to Ramsey. On the left, Ramsey trying to get it to Herb. Now his back is to the basket and he brings it out to Penn. 1:12 remaining. Buckeyes trailing by two. Ramsey on the left wing looking for Williams low. Ramsey with a drive, fadeaway jump. No good. And the rebound to Bailey on the left side. Rutgers gets it back, holding the two-point lead, 70-68. Here's Strickland with the ball on the right sideline. Holding, he brings it out to Brown. He looks left and then goes to the middle of Bailey. Turnaround, jump, no good. Rebound, Curtis Scott and Kelvin Ransey, and the Buckeyes have it back. 3:30 remaining. Ohio State trailing by two. Here's Penn with a deliberate dribble. Looking for Curtis Scott on the right, can't find him free. Now in trouble with a tough stop, Jamal gives it off to Kelvin Ramsey. Ramsey outside, driving against Strickland. Ramsey swings away, leaves it off for Jim Smith. Right back to Ramsey, low for Herb, turn around baseline, gets it! Again! Herb got 24 on, it's tied at 77. Okay, we have a tie ball game at Madison Square Garden. Gentlemen, the puck shot return, 3:08 left to go in the game. It's all tied up. Ohio State 70, Rutgers 70. Inbound to Brown for Rutgers. They're trying to break the tie, attacking to the front court. Ten on Brown, and he gets to the front court with a spinning dribble. On the left now, he stops at the sideline, in trouble, being hawked by Penn. Gets it underneath to Anderson, shot up, no good, but a foul on the play. And it's going to be against, I believe, Carter Scott. That's the case, it'll be his fourth of the game. So Scott now has four, Carter has 8 points in the game. The Buckeyes are led at the moment by Ramsey, who has 26, and Williams, who has 24. They supplied 50 of the Buckeyes, 70 points. Two for Abdel Anderson, who is 0 for 2 at the free throw line. And he has 14 points in the game. Anderson's free throw good. So Rutgers breaks the tie. First point and a half for Anderson. He had 14 at the break and was the leading scorer for Rutgers. Anderson again, he spins it away. No good, and the rebound to Herb Williams. So the Buckeyes can get the lead for the first time here in the second half. 71-70, they're down by a point. Got 10 outside with less than 2:40 to go in the game. Into the left corner, this is Ramsey. Back out to Curtis Scott, not Ramsey. He was free for a moment, back to Curtis Scott, back to Ramsey. Takes the jump and brings it back out to Scott on the right side to Penn. He'll hold down, bring it off on the left to Curtis Scott, to Ramsey in the left corner. looking for Herb Lowe to cut his gun for the drive, and a shot from 12. No good. Half by Jim Smith, no good. Half again, no good. The rebound out to Anderson. Hunter's cut goes down. Here's a pass ahead to Brown. On the right to Strickland for a 15-footer. In and out, no good. Rebound in the lane, and a traveling violation is going to be called here against Troy of Rutgers. He lost his balance and traveled with a basketball.
Of the top 10, I'm sure everyone is aware, three of the top 10 teams are Big Ten teams. Michigan State, number 4, Illinois, number 6, and Michigan is number 8. We were saying a while ago that the polls will certainly change when they come out next Tuesday, as Duke is the number 1 rated team this week. They lost to Ohio State here last night, losing again tonight in the consolation game to St. John's. Notre Dame playing later tonight against Kentucky. UCLA is the number 3 rated team, followed by the Spartans of Michigan State. North Carolina presently number 5, Illinois 6, LSU 7, Michigan 8, North Carolina State 9, and Louisville staying in there in the top 10 as they are the number 10 rated team. Bottom 10 find Indiana State, Texas A&M, Kentucky, and then Georgetown, Marquette, Long Beach State, Kansas, Syracuse, and Arkansas. So, three Big Ten teams in the top 8 and three ACC teams in the top 10. And it's certainly been a weekend of Big Ten against ACC, as we've had the action here as well as last night in Jacksonville, Florida. Another note on the bowl game coming up on Monday. Remember, the Sports Ohio Network, along with WBNS Radio, will have the mutual broadcasting feed for the Sugar Bowl, which has Penn State number 1 against Alabama number 2, and then Monday night from Miami, Florida, the rematch of Oklahoma and Nebraska. And that'll be an 8 o'clock ball game on Monday night. Plenty of sports action your way this holiday weekend. 2 minutes exactly left on the clock. Kind of reminds you of the 2-minute warning. As Rutgers has a 71-70 lead, Ohio State with the ball. Once again, John Gordon. Penn to Scott. Back to Penn on the left side. Scott on the right. Into the corner on the right side to Ramsey. Against the zone. Carter Scott back to Ramsey. Doesn't take a jump and then holds the ball. Now puts it on the floor along the right sideline and brings it back out to Carter Scott. To Penn on the left. Rutgers in a 3-2 zone. Jim Smith outside for Ohio State. Ramsey from long range. No good. Rebound on the left to Bailey. And Rutgers wants the timeout. 2 minutes to go and they call the last timeout. The Buckeyes take it down and Ramsey's jump was way off the mark. 1:29 to go and the timeout with a 71-70 score. We are going to stay here at Madison Square Garden during the timeout and remind everyone that Big Ten action will begin at St. John Arena this coming Thursday night as the Ohio State Buckeyes open up with the Purdue Boilermakers. And we might also remind you that those of you that perhaps are going to be in the Columbus area, and of course all of our listeners in Columbus, that we have 1,000 tickets that will go on sale for the Ohio State-Purdue game Tuesday morning. And the ticket office will open at 9 o'clock. We'll be open all day until 5 on Tuesday. So if you can, by chance, get in to see the Ohio State Buckeyes Thursday when we return home from this ECAC Holiday Classic. We want to see each and every one of you there and welcome the Buckeyes out onto the floor in a big, big manner when we do get home. Saturday, we'll face the Badgers of Wisconsin, and that'll be a Saturday night game. Both games are scheduled at tip-off at 8:10, and we'll be broadcasting both starting at 7:50 with the Elvin Miller Show on Thursday and Saturday night of next week.
Rutgers inbounding in the backcourt, and the inbound pass will come to Madlinger, who's back in the game, to Anderson, now to Brown. And everybody backing away, and now top 10 picking up Brown. Less than a minute, 20 to go in the game. Here's Brown to the front court, leaving it off for Madlinger now, with Carter Scott on him. And Madlinger brings it back to Brown with 10 right on him. And left for Anderson outside with Jim Smith on it. Back to Brown, nearly stolen away, but Brown controls. Now holding against Pat Penny, brings it on the left sideline to Bailey. Back out to Anderson. 57 seconds remaining, and Rutgers leading by 71-70, and they have the ball. Here's Brown outside against Penn, the Madeline. 46 seconds to go to Clark. Clark trying to get away from Ransey, driving on the right.
Three-point Rutgers lead at this time, and the Buckeyes will certainly have their work cut out for them as play will resume momentarily at Madison Square Garden. Understand that we have terrible fog back in Columbus, as Fort Columbus, in fact, was closed earlier today because of the fog situation. As it stands right now, the Ohio State Buckeyes are due to arrive back in Columbus tomorrow morning at 11:05, and we hope that the fog situation clears up a little more. And although it's been just a tremendous holiday visit to New York City, I think we're all ready to go home, and we don't want any delays in Pittsburgh or any place else. So we're due back in Columbus tomorrow morning at 11:05. As the Ohio State Buckeyes will be wrapping up this ECAC Festival Tournament here with 40 seconds left on the clock. 73-70 is the score, and the Buckeyes will be putting the ball in play. You can bet Jim Young has instructed his ball club, do not foul whoever takes the shot. A three-point play would be ideal right here for Ohio State. Back to the action, and again, John Gordon. Ohio State has one timeout left, and here we go. The ball into Scott 10, 38 seconds remaining to Ransey. Kelvin quickly to the free throw line, driving, foul on the play. Stops the clock, and Ransey goes for two at the line. He'll try for his 1,000th point right here. He's going to get two free throws in. He's got 26 in the game. If he gets both of them home, he'll have 1,000 points here. And his scoring career for Ohio State. And it would bring the Buckeyes within one of Rutgers with 32 seconds remaining. And here's Ransey at the line. Calvin's free throw good. Oh, Ransey now has 1,000 points in his career. 999. Now he needs this one for his 1,000. Here comes Madlinger. Clark back in the game, replacing McDaniel. And Troy coming out. Substitutions by Tom Young. Colin Williams is fourth of the game. And at the line will be Bailey for two. It's a one-point Rutgers lead. Here's Bailey free throw. No good. No. 28 seconds remain. Bailey missed the first of the pair. Bailey again, he got it. The Buckeyes with one timeout remaining. And they're going to get it down in a hurry. Here's Pat Penn calling. To go. 2 point Rutgers lead. TJ? Well, John, you can't say it hasn't been an exciting tournament. With 22 seconds left in the game, the Ohio State Buckeyes purposely went to mid-floor before they called their timeout, so they'll be putting the ball in play on their own end of the basketball court. This is what it's all about, strategy and coaching. Eldon Miller with his Ohio State Buckeyes, Jim Young with his Rutgers basketball team, and you can imagine what the instructions are in each. of the huddle.
Once again, our attendance tonight, 16,369. The two-day attendance figures, 34,958. That means an average of 17,479 per night. And that establishes a new average record for this holiday classic. The old record was set 10 years ago in 1968 when 15,609 came in and averaged attendance for this holiday classic. The Ohio State Buckeyes trail by two. There are 22 seconds left on the clock, and we're looking for victory number two. In New York City, after last night's win over Duke, looking to get back into this one with 22 seconds left to go in the contest. Kelvin Ransey became the 13th Ohio State basketball player to score 1,000 points, as he has exactly that right now with his 28 points in this basketball game tonight.
Here we go, pen on the left for Ransey. Back out to Penn, looking for Ransey, low for her.
Well, okay, folks, this will certainly be a fast and furious 7 seconds without question, as it's all tied up now at Madison Square Garden. And once again, let's say about the football. In case you missed it earlier today, in the AFC playoffs, Pittsburgh defeated Denver by a 33-10 count in Pittsburgh and at Dallas. Dallas coming from behind to defeat Atlanta, that final 27-20. Tomorrow in the AFC, Houston with New England. In the NFC, Minnesota with Los Angeles. And remember, on Monday, we have the Sugar Bowl and Orange Bowl action for you across the WBNS Sports Ohio network. The Sugar Bowl will come, of course, from New Orleans, where number one rated Penn State plays number two rated Alabama. The Orange Bowl from Miami, Florida, Nebraska, and Oklahoma with their rematch football game. And all adds up to an exciting weekend of sports activity for our radio audience. We've had a couple of good ones here in New York, and 7 seconds remaining in regulation time as the Ohio State Buckeyes must hold here. Rutgers will be coming out with their game plan. It's all tied up 74 feet.
Now the Buckeyes have to hope for overtime here, or for a steal in a last-second shot to win the game. Madlinger will bring it inbound. And it's full-court pressure. It's ahead to Brown. Brown loses the ball. Let's go with a foul. Offense. The Ohio State has the ball. 4 seconds to go, and Brown fouled in the first. And the Buckeyes get it back. Now the Buckeyes have the basketball. 4 seconds to go, and they're going to get it out of bounds. They have to take it length of the floor in 4 seconds. Brown was racing to the basket and ran into Kelvin Ramsey and fouled him. Now Ohio State has to take it length of the floor. And here's the pass to Ramsey. Ramsey is a timeline. They have time. It's in the air.
Let's break for 60 right here as the regulation ends in a tie. Ohio State 74, Rutgers 74.
S-T-E-N-C-E-R.
Spencer Tire is what we are.
Have you ever taken a good look at the performance tires that keep showing up in pictures and performance magazines? You know, the ones with raised white letters and a wide, aggressive tread? Chances are they're B.F. Goodrich Radial TA tires. Why? B.F. Goodrich sells as many raised white-letter radial tires as anyone. Performance buffs know our radial TA tires are tough, with a strong, aggressive tread that can handle anything on or off the road. B.F. Goodrich tested them against race car tires at Le Mans, Watkins Glen, Sebring, and the racetracks of the world. TA Radials prove they can take the punishment and win. That's why you see so many TA 50, 60, and 70s in magazines. Get them now at Spencer Tire and Oil Company at the junction of Routes 162 and 301 in Spencer. Only at Spencer Tire and B.F. Goodrich.
Tonight it's 74-74 with Rutgers, 5 minutes going on the clock for the overtime period. Back to the action, once again, John Gordon. Herb Williams against James Bailey on the jump. Williams has four fouls on him, Carter Scott's got four. And the tap control, it's two. Rutgers, Troy's got it. He'll give off to Moore in the overtime. Starts with Rutgers and a chance to lead. Tied in regulation at 74. Bailey underneath, missed the layup. And the rebound is picked up by Carter, by Rick Jim Smith. He gives off to Carter Scott, out of top 10. The Buckeyes, with 4:39 remaining in the overtime, will have a chance for the lead here. This is Herb Williams low. Herb with a turnaround, it's up and short. He rebounds it, puts it up again and missed it. Back in by Carter Scott. And the Buckeyes lead here by two, 76-74. Carter Scott was hurt in the play, and he's coming off to the bench. Scott, after Williams had missed two, stuck it in, and the Buckeyes lead.
Trainer Mike Boydner is looking at Carter at this time. Carter went up and got the stiff in, and apparently came down wrong on an ankle. Now, Mike Klein is ready to come in if he has to, but the situation is right here that we have an official timeout on the floor for Carter Scott. Mike Boydner, the trainer, is training, looking to him at this time, and we do have a pause in the action. 4 minutes and 23 seconds remaining. The Bucks are up by two, and the alley-oop was simply missed by Rutgers when they came down the floor. Action back in.
All right, this is going to be Brown outside against Penn. He's to the left sideline in the front court. Looking low, he gets it to Bailey on the left corner. Bailey against Herb Williams, brings it out to Brown. Out on top, he goes on the left to Anderson for the drive. Anderson, heavy traffic, puts it up there. High game. Anderson's first second half basket. And he now has 17 in the game. 76-76, 10 left sideline. Stopping in the wing. Out to Ransey. He holds now. Ramsey driving at the 15-foot mark. It's up. It's in. Ramsey now is 28 a game. Here's a steal by Penn. He lays it up and in. Todd Penn stole the ball and laid it in. And the Buckeyes now lead it 80-76. 3:29 to go. This is Brown outside. On the left to Bailey. The jump of the baseline. Good. It's a big basket. And he's got 24 for Rutgers. But the Buckeyes have the lead in the ball. They're up by two with 3:13 to go. Penn on the right sideline. At the wing. Brings it back out to Klein, who's into the game. Now for Carter Scott. Here's Klein off to Ramsey. Driving on the left. Brings it back out to Klein. Off on the right to Penn. The drive underneath for Jim Smith. Right back out to Penn again. Right corner, Todd Penn. Low for Williams, banged away and out of bounds. Give Ramsey 30 in the game. Buckeyes ball, final inbound to Ramsey, the jump on the leg, yes! Ramsey now with 32. 15 baskets in the game for Kelvin. Here's a near steal. Buckeyes by four, 82-78. 2:38 remaining, a drive. Strickland jump up and good. So Strickland gets the basket. And it's a two-point Ohio State lead. 82-80. We've got 2:23 remaining in the overtime. The Buckeyes and the Rutgers German Knights tied at 74. Here's Penn on the right for a drive. A layup, no good. And he's fouled in the play. Kelvin Ransey with his 32 points. This is now his highest point productivity for any night as an Ohio State Buckeye. So it's really been a double production thing for Kelvin tonight, reaching the 1,000 point plateau and also surpassing his previous high of 31 points. And that came against Miami earlier this season on November 30.
Penn makes the free throw. Buckeyes by three. Has Penn. Hit for Ohio State. He's got 3 points in the game. Penn again. Good. Now the Buckeyes lead by 484-80. 2:12 remaining. Right down to the wire in overtime. Rutgers attacking. Strickland driving. Strickland 15 footer up and good. Boy, Rutgers won't quit. And now Strickland with 13 in the game. 2-point Ohio State lead. 1:58 to go. 84-82. Buckeyes with the lead in the ball. Here's Penn on the right side. He's got it heavily by Brown. Brings it out to Jim Smith. Right back to Penn. Holding now on the right side. He brings it out to Smith. Right back to Penn again. Penn looking for Ransey. Finds him out near the timeline. And then Todd dribbles passing. Controls the dribble and brings it back out to Ransey. Ohio State now may play it down with 1:33 remaining. Decline from Ransey, right back to Ransey. Here's a drive by Calvin, out to Hurd. He drives and loses the ball. Stolen away by Rutgers. And they could tie here with 1:20 remaining. Brown, front center, and to the front court. Leaving it on the right. He gets it to Bailey. Turn around, jump, no good. Kept away, Ransey to the hands of Penn. Ohio State has it. Penn with a drive and an offensive foul on Todd Penn. Todd Penn with an offensive foul and Rutgers gets it back. It won't be shooting here, I don't believe. Should be ball control and it is. 1:05 remaining. In the overtime, the Buckeyes leading 82-84-82. Trying to hang on for a win here to claim the title in the ECAC Holiday Festival. Penn on Brown. And Brown spinning away on the right. Leaves it for Strickland outside. He holds now and brings it on the left to Bailey. Against Herb Williams, Bailey brings it back out to Brown. Less than 45 seconds to go. Anderson underneath. Loose down the deck and a jump call between Herb Williams and Kelvin Cole.
41 seconds left in the overtime. Ohio State with the height advantage on the jump and a two-point lead.
Herb Williams, 6'11 against Kelvin Troy, 6'10. The tap control to Mike Klein. The Buckeyes have it with less than 40 seconds to go in the overtime, leading by two. Here's Penn to the front court, right sideline. Penn going all the way at the wing, brings it back out for Mike Klein. Nearly stolen away. Klein holds and gets it to Ransey. Ransey outside with 23 seconds to go. Ransey, 2-3 men controlling the dribble. Ransey again!
That was the only thing that could happen as Coach Jim Young was up and instructing someone on his Rutgers team to foul Kelvin Ransey. Kelvin was going to keep the dribble, and now we're down to 18 seconds. Kelvin going to the free throw line and try to add to his 32 points tonight.
Now Ransey can make one or two. The Buckeyes might be able to start up. 18 seconds remaining. 84-82, here's Ransey. It's up, it's in. Ransey with a remarkable night, 33 points. Ransey again trying for his 34th, and Rutgers wants the timeout.
Well, John, it's a three-point lead at this time, and when we get back into the action, the Ohio State Buckeyes will go to the free throw line once again. Kelvin Ransey will try for a four-point lead with the 18 seconds left to go. Once again, we return home and open up the Big Ten season for 1979 as we will have the Ohio State-Purdue game on the air this Thursday night. We'll be looking forward to seeing many of you at St. John Arena. Those of you that will not be able to get there, be sure to be listening as we'll take the air at 7:50 with the Elder Miller Show.
And then we turn around on Saturday night and host Wisconsin. The Badgers will be in. And once again, 8:10 tip-off time, 7:50 air time on the WBNS Sports Ohio, Ohio State Basketball Network. I'll be curious to find out the condition of Carter Scott. Carter went out of the ball game very early in the overtime. He came down on an ankle that appeared to be from here. Mike Boydner, the trainer, was tending to him, and Carter Scott has not returned to the lineup to this point. 85-82. Last night we went to overtime with the Duke Blue Devils, tied it at 76-76. Never did we lead in the ball game in regulation time, winning it by a score of 90-84. Those of you that were with us and thought we finished it out with 90-82, there was a goaltending call on a last effort shot at the end of the ball game. The bucket was counted. That's why the 90-84. Kelvin Ransey back to the line and will try for the extra point.
It is up and in. Ransey now is 34 points in the game. What a game by the sophomore, the junior from Toledo. Here's the play, and there's a foul call, and it's going to be on Cliff Kirchner's into the game for Mike Klein. Offensive foul on, a foul called on Klein with a block. He was trying to draw the offensive foul. Boy, that hurt. 16 seconds to go, and the foul called. Ohio State certainly didn't want that. Not at all. Just 2 seconds elapsing on the clock. Ohio State by four. 86-82. But Rutgers can cut it down to two here with Strickland at the free throw line. The foul on Klein is third. Strickland a 1-1. If he makes the first, he'll get the second. And here's the toss by Strickland. It's up and no good. Rebound out of bounds. Jump ball. Strickland missed. And a jump ball is going to be called at the Rutgers end. So the Buckeyes get a break in the missed free throw. It'll be Bailey 6-9 against Herbingham 6-11. 15 seconds remain. Top control. Out of bounds. Who's ball? It's going to be Rutgers ball. 13 seconds remain. Gets it out of bounds. They trail by four. Strickland outside against Ramsey. The drive, the shot. Oh, Ramsey. See if the basket counts. I don't believe it will. No basket. Ramsey fouls. Strickland to the free throw line. BJ?
Well, all of the coaches are off the bat. Coach Jerry Sears, who, by the way, will be with us after the ball game tonight, along with Chuck Mayshot up off the bench, Eldon Miller up off the bench once again, and Coach Mayshot heading now for the scorer's table. The basket does not count. We will go to the 1-1. Our Buckeye wrap-up show will be heard tonight. Coach Jerry Sears will be our guest as we discuss this championship game of the ECAC basketball tournament from Madison Square Garden. 8 seconds left to go in the game. A 4-point Ohio State lead.
That is Strickland, 1-1. Free throw up and good. Cuts it down to three. Rutgers does not have any timeouts left, so Strickland will shoot this one, and then they'll have to try to keep Ohio State from getting the ball in play. If Strickland hits, he'll cut it down to two. 8 seconds left. Here's Strickland now at the line. Free throw. Good. He hit them both. Strickland's got two. And now the substitution in. Buckeyes against full court pressure. They lead by two. 8 seconds remain. Inbound to Ramsey. Double team. Ramsey in trouble. Team. They're a local team.
cannot believe the excitement that we've had in the ECAC tournament. Let's take another 60 right here. At the end of the first overtime period, with a score, Ohio State 86, Rutgers 86.
Think, will there be a gasoline shortage? Rationing gas for a dollar or more a gallon? Then think about new car prices. Those are just a few of the reasons why, if you're thinking about a new car, you should be thinking Honda cars. Honda, famous for good mileage, quality, and low cost. The best place to buy a Honda car is Prout on East Broad Street at the Route 57 bypass in Elyria. Prout with great selection and excellent service. If you think the Honda cars are too small, you probably haven't seen the latest Honda has to offer. New for 1979 is the Honda Accord 4-door. The Accord 4-door now offers family car roominess without the sacrifice of Honda economy, and an array of standard features that include steel-belted radial tires.
Takes the shot and gives the corner in the right corner. Back to Ransey against the zone. Off on the left to Penn. Holding now, the Buckeyes may drop away with 2:30 remaining and use the clock in their favor. Rutgers in the zone will be forced out of it now after the referee draws the warning. Here's Klein, double team, shovel passing to Penn, left sideline, right back to Klein, off to her to Jim Smith, back to Penn. Penn at the free throw line, dribbles to the right side, and then comes outside. Now Penn driving to the lane, 10-footer, yes! The Buckeyes lead. A 90-88 score. Clark in the backcourt to the front court on the right sideline. He'll hold the dribble and bring it to the middle. Now he gets it to Bailey. Turn around, jump off the board. Up and good. Bailey now with 26 in the game. Tied at 90 and 144 remaining. What a game here in the finals of the ECAC Holiday Classic. The Buckeyes trying to wrap it up. As at the moment, they lead and are tied with Rutgers at 90-90. Here's Penn outside, 1:27 remaining. Now to Ransey. He holds as he's guarded by Troy. Ransey off to Klein. Klein in the middle on the dribble. Spinning away, looking for Ransey, finds him free. 1:15 remaining. Second overtime, Ransey to Penn. Penn driving. Stopping, driving again in the corner to Jim Smith. Back outside to Ransey.
15 going into the ball game. Notre Dame rated number 2.
Here we go. Penn has the ball and a 90-90 tie with a minute to go. Now 56 seconds remain. Here's Penn outside. We got a whistle and someone has thrown something on the floor. And to play. 51 seconds remain. 90-90 tie. 47 seconds remain. Penn to Ransey outside. 40 seconds to go. My guys will try to play it down, I'm sure. To Klein. Klein now double team. Driving, slipping, and falling. But it is saved and then a traveling violation caught on Mike Klein. What a tough break. What a tough break. Mike Klein slipped and fell, and they caught traveling. It was an aid. Anything but just a slip by Mike Klein as he was driving at the free throw line. He wasn't going in for a shot. He just slipped and fell down and traveling was called. Sideline in the backcourt on the far side, and he gets it into Brown. 31 seconds left to go. Now Brown trying to get to the front court against Penn, brings it off to Madlinger on the left sideline. Madlinger gives it to Strickland. He'll bring it to Brown on the right. Brown to Anderson, way outside against Jim Smith, down to Madlinger. 16 seconds to go. This is the second overtime. Rutgers playing for a final shot to try to win it. Here's Brown. He gets it to Bailey. Bailey, Bailey shoots! No good! Shot, no good! Rebound, Ohio State! 2 seconds left, timeout, Ohio State! 1 second to go. Well, the Buckeyes were able to get control of the basketball. One must feel that a triple overtime will be in order here at Madison Square Garden. 1 second to go. The Ohio State will have to put the ball in play on the Rutgers end of the floor. Crying, driving, and double-teamed back to Pennamore. They'll pen to the free throw line. Pen all the way. Trying to dig up and does to Williams. Now Williams brings it back out to Penn. Oh, Rutgers went an offensive charge on Penn, but they didn't get it. Now Penn with a drive again. Backing away, gives Darlinghausen right back to Penn. A minute to go in the third overtime. Ohio State ball one. Klein outside. Now Klein double-teamed. Moves away, he's triple-teamed. In trouble, he's fouled by Bill Clark.
51 seconds remaining on the clock, and Mike Klein will be going to the free throw line with a 1-1 for Ohio State.
1, free throw, in and out, no good. Rebound, Rutgers ball. The Buckeyes go 2-1-1. Rutgers with a chance to win, and 45 seconds to go. They travel 1. Here's Anderson, back to Brown, on the left, he takes the open jump. In trouble, now he gets it low, but there it is. Remain, Ohio State will call timeout. 97-96, Bailey's drive and step from the left gives Rutgers the lead.
And of course, Bailey going right through the hoop, Herb Williams.
In the left corner to Klein, back out to Ransey. The Buckeyes now to buy a pen. With 11 seconds to go to Ransey. Ransey with his move to the basket. To Klein. Klein back to Ransey.